ship of the imagination, fueled by equal parts of science and wonder, can take us anywhere in space and time. It can travel faster than light and render visible those things that cannot be seen. It's carrying us to a mysterious realm that lies one light year from the sun. What is this swarm of worlds? Was it organized by alien beings? No, just gravity.
These are the snows of yesteryear, drifting mountains of ice and rock, the preserved remnants of the birth of the solar system. It's called the Oort cloud, after Jan Oort, the Dutch astronomer who foretold its existence back in 1950. He was trying to solve a paradox. There's so many ways for comets to die. Because they cross the orbits of planets, comets frequently collide with them. Comets are largely made of ice, so every time they come near the sun, they lose a part of themselves through evaporation. And after several thousand trips, their ice is all gone. What remains of the comet is now an asteroid. Comets can be gravitationally ejected from the solar system and exiled into space. And yet somehow, the comets keep coming. Oort and other astronomers wondered, where do all the comets come from?
Oort calculated the rate at which new comets appear and concluded that there must be a vast spherical swarm of them a few light years across surrounding the sun.
Oort's logic still holds up, even after all the discoveries we've made about comets in the solar system in the many decades since. And yet, the Oort cloud is a sight that no one has ever seen. Nor could we. It's dark out here, and each comet is about as far from its closest neighbor as the Earth is from Saturn. But science gives us special powers of our own. It gave Jan Oort the gift of prophecy. Oort was also the first to correctly estimate the distance between the sun and the center of our galaxy. That's a big deal, finding out where we are in the Milky Way. Our star is about 30,000 light years from the center. Oort was also the first guy to use a radio telescope to map the galaxy's spiral structure. And he discovered that the center of our galaxy was a place of titanic explosions. The first indication that there might have been a supermassive black hole lurking there. Does the fact that most of us know the names of mass murderers, but never heard of Jan Oort, say anything about us?